Yeah,
you know?
life's an adventure either way. It's just all about what adventure do you want?
Yeah.
You want the adventure of watching Netflix and consuming bad food, consuming bad information, and dealing with fighting and bickering and shit on the news? Or do you want to have the adventure of going and exploring and thinking for yourself for the rest of your life? You know, which one? What's going on, guys? Welcome to the welcome back to the Free Rein 6M podcast. It's just Kristian and I again.
How's it going?
Just fucking cranking out content all fucking day. We're gonna be out at Russell's today, but that didn't happen. Blew his truck up, so things are moving a little differently today. How do you think the day's been going? We've been kind of just figuring some shit out.
Yeah, man, we're just getting into the rotation of our new schedule. Talked a little bit about that yesterday. Which, are we going to be using that at all, posting that?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that episode is up by now.
Okay, then yeah, you guys will definitely see that.
Understand.
So we got a new schedule rolling. It's just another new day of trying to get used to it.
It's tough. Yeah. It's tough to put out, like, not only put out that amount of content, but to make it all meaningful and worth it for everybody.
Yeah.
Just another level. We're getting a little frustrated with ourselves, it seems like, with, you know, just fucking with the algorithm, man, that big old monster, you know, it's just fucking figuring that thing out. And I think, you know, we just got to push this amount of content for months and you know, we'll come out on top. But talking about how we can, you know, looking forward to these trips and displaying that properly, which, you know, we're with this content, you know, we have a fucking purpose within the brand that's relayed through the content.
Yeah.
You know, we're here to push for freedom, to make people aware that they are free and how important that is. You know, everybody has the idea of, but there's legitimate things moving against our freedom that, you know, there needs to be a fucking brand or brands and people and groups of people pushing against that shit.
Yeah.
And saying no more. You know, there's just so much fucking stupid shit going on in the world. And we just want to be that fucking brand that steps in and just says no more.
Yeah.
Without really saying it, you know, if we have to, you know, but we want to push through naturally and with a fucking positive mindset.
Yeah.
But, you know, there's just so much crazy shit going on in the world, and it helps to have companies like us. And, you know, we're small, but there's bigger companies out there that are, you know, owned by the right people that can push against that shit. So where we come in is, you know, we fucking travel, we, you know, go outdoors, we fucking motorsports and shit, and we use that to preach this message.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
That's really the only way we know how. You know, if we just want to be authentic, we want to be real, we want to fucking showcase the shit that we already do and our friends already do. Mm-hmm. And, you know, for a fucking purpose, right?
Yeah. And push other people to do that too.
Yeah.
I mean, I made a post today talking about short little clip from our thing out in our trip out to California at the beginning of this year. But man, there's a lot more to nature and being outdoors than just seeing something pretty, you know, there's a lot of growing, a lot of spaces where you can go just to kind of clear your mind, get a lot of peace, get a lot of really just like serenity in life, to really think about the things that are going on in your life, you know.
Yeah.
I think being outside in nature, being, you know, living your freedom, living in that freedom, there's a lot, like I said, there's a lot of learning, there's a lot of growing that you can do just within yourself that I think is really important that everybody needs to kind of experience, you know?
Yeah. Yeah. And it's, you know, being outdoors, and that is where we're supposed to be. You know, we have fucking evolved and created the technology and advanced technology for the sake of who knows why, but, you know, we are supposed to be outside. We're supposed to be fucking feet on the dirt. You know, it sounds gross and shit. You know, it's a little off from the modern world, but, you know, we are supposed to be outside. We're supposed to experience the outdoors and all this shit that's going on in the world. They They don't want you in the sun. They don't want you outside. They don't want you consuming good knowledge. They want you to be fucking stupid, fat, and lazy. And that's not what we're about. So we're here to get people outside, to get people on their fucking dirt bike and their side by side. Say, fuck that shit and just fucking feed your freedom and embrace your freedom. That's all we're fucking doing. You know, I said in the interview the other day, you know, you fucking get out there and it's a different fucking state of mind that you run into when you're all on your own.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have to fucking depend on nothing. All the shit that's going on in the world, on the news, on social media, all that bullshit is fucking non-existent. And when you're out there and you experience that, you will fucking understand what the fuck we're talking about.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
That's what it's all about, man. So, yeah, being positive about it, of course, you know, I get fired up a little bit and usually don't, but now I am. And, you know, I'm just fucking excited to fucking build this community and provide something meaningful for society.
Yeah. No, and I love that because I think that, I mean, I don't know. I think that that's exactly why this whole free rein media thing was started, was just to impact people and show them everything, you know?
Yeah.
We've been going on a lot of trips. We have a lot of trips coming up this next month, which we're kind of getting prepped for, kind of amidst us getting this studio put together. Maybe do you want to kind of talk about or kind of overview of what trips we have coming up next month?
We've talked about it a little bit, and we have a float trip that everybody's welcome to join us on in Steel Creek in Arkansas, Buffalo River. We have like 18 spots booked for people that can camp and shit. So
yeah,
everybody's fucking welcome. Even the Alpine Loop trip, if you got a Jeep, if you got a 4Runner, if you got a fucking Tacoma, you know, you can come join us on the Alpine Loop trip out in the Rockies. You know, before that, we'll already be in Denver shooting for Righteous Tattoo. Shout out to Righteous Tattoo. Fucking
Donnie's one of the folks. Definitely excited about that trip with Donnie and Mandy.
Yeah, that's going to be fun. But what we have Cloud 9 after that. You know, it's just, dude, this, and we're spending our money on this shit. We're excited about it, knowing that we're, you know, we're not expecting some type of return off this shit right away. It's not the reason we're doing it. Of course, we need to keep our bills paid and all that, but we're going out here to fucking showcase this shit and to inspire people out in the fucking world.
Yeah.
So the whole month of July is full of trips.
Yeah, no, for
full
sure.
Of trips.
I mean, even kind of diving into like that first trip you talked about, with that canoe trip, the 14th through the 16th down in, Steel Creek, Arkansas, or is it Steel Creek, Arkansas, or is it Ponca and just Steel Creek is the campground?
Ponca's down the river. Steel Creek's just the campground. So Steel Creek campground, Buffalo River.
Gotcha. Yeah.
I don't even think Ponca's an actual town. I think it's like a mm-hmm. fucking, I think, I looked it up the other day and it mm-hmm. didn't, it said had some other wording to it. Mm-hmm. It's like basically like a corner with some houses.
I mean, but yeah, I mean, just talking about just that river in general, man, it's beautiful. I grew up like going down canoeing that with my stepdad. The house we used to live in, we had these two neighbors and we'd always go on float trips together. Tim and Tammy, they're super great people. We'd always take, we'd carpool all down there.
Mm-hmm.
So we'd have like three cars. We're full of like probably 10 kids.
Yeah.
Going down there, setting up camp, spending the whole weekend there.
Yeah.
Campfires, you know, some of the parents are drinking, whatever. Kids are out there just having fun, man. It's just, it's a different experience being, like growing up going down there, you know?
Yeah. And look at you now, you're here doing the free rein shit and going right back. You know, that's an important fucking thing. Get your kids outside.
Yeah.
Get them off the shit, off the iPads.
Yeah, get the tablets out of
the
shit
they're teaching them in these fucking schools. Fuck that shit.
It's ridiculous.
Get them outside. Bring them down to Steel Creek, Arkansas. Let them fucking swim in the clear ass water and shit. You know, let them experience the outdoors and you know, how life is meant to be.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, yeah. It's funny too, because like I've even had like interactions with some younger parents recently.
Yeah.
And like, there's parents that literally won't even let their kids like get in the creek. Like, my kid's gonna get too dirty and this and that. There's stuff in that creek. It's like,
kid's gonna grow up to be a soft ass motherfucker.
Yeah. Like,
this is how it's gonna be.
Like, let your kids adventure, let your kids explore, figure out life for themselves outside of them you know, getting directions from you to do everything. Like,
yeah,
our minds are built to explore and to learn and to, you know, to go out and, you know, once we get to that certain age, we're meant to go out and do our own thing. And like, yeah. But if you shelter somebody for, you know, a kid for so long, you're going to push them out of the house. And at yeah. some point they're going to break down and not know what to do. They're not going to have any sort of defense mechanism. And when it comes to those things going through life and stuff like that. So
yeah, it's really tough on any human being to grow and expand when you're stuck in an office, when you're stuck in a fucking yeah. school that's fucking pushing shit in your brain that don't need to be there. You know, when you're stuck, when your kid's stuck in the house on the iPad, where is that going to lead to?
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. So yeah, I mean, it comes down to what are you teaching your kids at home?
Yeah. And I have two girls, so I take them outside. I take them up to my uncle's, take them up to the farm. They love the fucking cows. They love to be out in the backyard. They love to have a fire. They love to pick up the sticks, put them in the fire pit. You know, they love to be outside. They love Paul's side by side. They love all that shit. And they know about it. They're aware. They would rather be outside, you know. And just a little fucking tip. If you're fucking sick of your kids driving you nuts inside, you send them motherfuckers outside and wear them out.
Mm-hmm.
They get back inside, go to sleep about 6:30, 7 o'clock.
Yeah. Well, it's funny because you put a kid outside and they're just so curious already, as a kid. And I just, the restrictions that so many parents have, it's just let your kids go out. Like literally every time we go outside, it's I feel like I almost have more of an eye on your kids than you do, because you're just we'll go outside. JJ's yep, they're playing. Yeah. And I'm like, oh my God, JJ, what?
That's how I grew up. My dad just sent, we literally, we were little fucking kids. And of course, we lived down at the lake, so it was a little easier, but he'd just send us out and we'd go in the woods. We'd go down in the valley and do our own thing,
Yeah.
Growing up, in fucking elementary, I would be at the creek with my cousin Taylor. All fucking day, every fucking day, catching them cray dads, just hanging out, jumping off the cliff into the creek, And that's what I love doing now.
Yeah.
You know?
That's true. I mean, obviously that's instilled something in you and even, looking at Zane as well. You guys both have that just innate nature just to want to be outside because that it brings healing in a way.
Yeah, life's an adventure either way. It's just all about what adventure do you want?
Yeah.
You want the adventure of watching Netflix and consuming bad food, consuming bad information and dealing with fighting and bickering and shit on the news, or do you want to have the adventure of going and exploring and thinking for yourself for the rest of your life? Which one?
Yeah. Yeah, that's true.
So yeah, that's what we're about, man. We're out here just fucking embracing freedom, and we want others to embrace freedom the same and whatever way makes you happy. We believe that freedom is the nucleus of happiness.
Yep. Yeah, no, that's true.
You have to be free. If you are not free, how could you be happy? I don't know.
Yeah. I mean, I don't even know if
think about being not being free. Think about how that affects society. Think about in a non-free society, you can't progress as easily or at all to the next class of people.
Yeah.
You're probably stuck in the same fucking place, and your kids will probably be stuck in the same fucking place.
Yeah.
And your whole the next generations of your families will be fucked, and everybody's gonna be fucked. So we literally have to show everybody how important freedom is, because there was one point in time where America was all about that shit, and America was a lot different.
Mm-hmm.
America's a lot fucking different now.
Yeah,
and everybody knows what the fuck I'm talking about.
Whether you like to think
wherever the fuck you're at, we ain't about that shit. We're just about freedom, and that's fucking it. You want to fight and bitch about whatever, fuck all that shit. You can go fucking watch the news.
Go fucking kick rocks or something.
That's about it.
Yeah, go watch the news if you don't want to hear about freedom.
Yeah.
Because, you're right. It's without that freedom, you don't even have the free will to make your own choices. You just have, everything's fed to you, whether it's knowledge, food, or, you know, everything else. It's like, whenever you're just handed everything, you have no, like,
you have no responsibility.
You have no purpose. You have no purpose to do. Like, you have no purpose to live if you don't have freedom.
Yeah.
You know?
I mean,
because, like, if I tell you to do everything in your life, it's like your life isn't based off of what you want to do or like what you like to do or anything like that. Like,
yeah,
you're
it's
just
fucking robotic.
You're just living your life
to be like that.
Yeah. It's just like, you have like this, like you're like a puppet, just a bunch of puppets, just like walking around, and there's just no like true meaning or like
sheep.
Yeah. No, literally it's like no true meaning behind life. It's like,
yeah,
it's a whole thing.
So yeah, man, we're all pushing through that. We're all dealing with it, whether we're completely aware of it or not. We're all dealing with it. There's a lot of crazy shit going on in this world, and hopefully, moving forward on the podcast, we can keep having great conversations like this. But
yeah,
if you like this episode, go ahead and comment and let us know what you think, or maybe what you want to hear from us moving forward.
Yeah, what are some topics you guys want to hear about?
We got a shit ton of work to do on this content. To, you know, what we were just talking about, just pushing out a shit ton of content. We got a lot of work to do, so
yeah,
we'll be back soon. Appreciate y'all.
Appreciate you.
Live your free reign.